from Creamer Media in Johannesburg, this is the Real Economy Report. The Council for Scientific and Industrial Research has, in partnership with Wright ePharmacy, developed a pharmacy automation robot for medicine dispensing. Tasnimble Bouya tells us more.
The AVA43 robot was produced locally by the CSIR at its premises in Pretoria and constitutes about 80% local materials. CSIR Executive Director Martin Sunny details the robot.
The medicine dispensing unit is a robotic assistant, so to speak, in a pharmacy dispensing scenario. So where you are regularly dispensing equal quantities of medicine, pre-packed, let's say, in sachets, it's easier for a little bit of robotics to do some packing and sorting in the background, okay, which alleviates the pharmacist's task a lot. So the technology behind it is obviously a robotic arm, a robotic sensor, so special camera which can sense exactly what it's picking up, suction caps that go to the device, to the actual sachet, pick up the sachet with the medicine inside, check it, okay, through a little bit of, I'll call it artificial intelligence, and then make sure it's the right one, print a label on it, and then drop it off into the dispensing unit where it then gets dispensed to the patient. And the trigger for it is normally a script or an input from a terminal outside, you know, like an ATM, and you obviously identify the patient via a special way, via fingerprint or iris recognition or via the script that they've put in. A pharmacist does talk to the patient normally as well, just to make sure that when, you know, it's the right person, check some, you know, the condition of the patient and so on. But then the actual dispensing process is automated, and that's really the fundamentals behind it. The development has been ongoing for about 1.5 years now. There are obviously other pharmacy automation companies in the world that do this type of thing as well. But the speciality for South Africa and for the African market has been the dispensing of sachets. Okay, so in the rest of the world it is not so common to dispense medication in sachets, which is plastic envelopes. So we were asked to help with the development of a unit for this specific purpose.
Sunny also spoke to the safety of the robot with measures in place to ensure it is not compromised.
That's part of the pharmacy process, so it integrates into the pharmacy itself. So it's not a standalone unit. It is run by professionals, so within a pharmacy, so it's really running in the background in a pharmacy. So it follows all pharmacy processes and protocols. So it's there's always pharmacists involved, and it's really only an assistant to a pharmacist. So it's you know, as safe as a normal pharmacy.
Sunny emphasized that the CSIR did not develop the robot to replace primary human jobs and responsibilities.
It's working in conjunction with pharmacists. It's making a pharmacist's job easier and faster, so that the pharmacist will be able to attend to more patients in a given time. So quite the opposite. We feel that it'll actually benefit to creating a better dispensing process and assisting pharmacists.
The robot was showcased by the CSIR during its Intelligent Manufacturing Systems Manuvation 4.0 workshop at the CSIR campus in Pretoria. The model that was showcased is a prototype, which will be installed in Alexandra in Johannesburg, where it will serve as the first test model. Through the trial project, the CSIR will be able to assess elements such as whether the software and parts are working correctly and if they are up to standard, as well as if the robot can work 24 hours a day and identify any problems and determine how to fix them. Once this process has been completed and the model is deemed of appropriate standard, the CSIR will seek to engage entities to mass-produce the robots. Marketing will be undertaken by Wright ePharmacy.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy.